Should I consume a white meat, red meat? Should I go for berry? Should I go for green leafy vegetables? Should I go for red cabbage? How about the fruits? Which are the best ones to consume? Should I go for the juice instead? Should I do a cleanse or maybe a supplement should do? These are some of the questions that you guys have been asking about which food groups to actually choose from when you're maintaining diabetes, whether it's type 1 or type 2 diabetes or even the pre-diabetes. Hi there and welcome once again. My name is Nduta Wambura, and if you're new here, you know what to do. Subscribe, put your notifications bell on, and let's keep growing this community. So if you're trying to maintain diabetes, or maybe you're taking care of somebody who has actually been diagnosed with diabetes, then this video is for you. So in the first place, what you need to know is that there's no one super food or super diet that you will go out there and buy that will take care of diabetes automatically. In any case, it's the same food groups that are available in your market that you would be able to use to maintain your diabetes day in, day out. So in any case, if someone is trying to sell you a diabetic diet or a diabetic superfood, please beware of that, because you need to actually be able to plan your meals using some very interesting techniques that are able to tweak and balance your insulin intake with the amount of food you're consuming or the amount of carbohydrates that you're consuming. And so in the first place, you need to choose from complex carbohydrates as opposed to simple carbohydrates. And the complex carbohydrates in this case would be from things like brown rice, brown chapati, brown ugali, and brown pasta. So yes, you are right. You should consume more of the complex carbohydrates as opposed to simple carbohydrates, because the complex carbohydrates take longer to be converted into blood sugar, and so you can be able to maintain your blood sugar level correctly. So you can use certain techniques to plan your meals, and these techniques would range from carbohydrate counting, like I spoke about on my previous video, and the plate method, whereby you can use observation. So you would have your plate, say, which is 9 inches, or depending on the plate size that you're using, and then divide it into three, and then have half of that plate with vegetables, the other quarter with protein, the other quarter with carbohydrates. And you can use this technique especially if you're eating out or you have gone to visit someone and you do not necessarily know how to estimate the amount of food that you need to consume. So you can use that method as well as the glycemic index method. So the glycemic index method would come handy when you are choosing your carbohydrates especially, and you would choose from the carbohydrates that have got a lower glycemic index as opposed to those with a very high glycemic index. And of course, this would be again like the brown rice, the brown pasta, brown ugali, anything that is actually not refined. So the other question would be about the proteins. So which proteins should you choose from as a diabetic? So I recommend that you go for plant proteins as opposed to animal proteins. And the very reason as to why you should do that is because the animal proteins, such as the processed meats and the red meats and so on, would be higher in saturated fat. And the higher the saturated fat intake, the higher your increase in the low density lipoprotein, or the bad fat, if you may. And this increases your coronary artery disease risk, and you do not want to be in such a place, because you're already trying to maintain diabetes as it is, and so you're always trying to also ensure that there are no other complications that come about when you're trying to maintain the diabetes. So go for the plant proteins, and the plant proteins would be from things like beans, the chickpeas. The beans can be either white or red. The chickpeas, the black-eyed peas, It can also be from lentils, the peas, depending again on the availability, the accessibility, the preferences in your food, depending on your family values and depending on where you are from and also your culture, then you can be able to choose from these plant proteins. Again, there have been a study that has linked the intake of eggs to diabetes, and I just want to put a disclaimer out there that this study was actually domiciled in one location and has not been necessarily been benchmarked rather into other countries. So I would be very cautious with the eggs. In any case, I would at least recommend at least one or two boiled eggs within a week for a diabetic. However, we still do not know exactly whether this intake of the eggs would actually affect insulin resistance. So that study is quite controversial, and I have had quite a number of you ask me about the eggs and the diabetes. So it's quite a controversial study, and there's still a lot of research that is needs to be carried out for it to be published and be used into different other countries. So the other thing that you also need to ensure is that you're consuming the correct fats, and you are choosing from the unsaturated fats. So in this case, you would go for the avocados, the nuts, and of course the cooking oil. You would choose from things like olive oil. That way, these types of fat do not have a very high amount of saturated fat as well as the trans fat. And of course, for the very reason that you do not want to increase your low density lipoprotein, which would also mean that you are at a risk of coronary artery disease. So the fats would be from, again, things like nuts, avocados, sunflowers, rapeseed, and be able to read the container, the nutrition facts on the container of the cooking oil that you actually buy, such that you are aware of the amount of saturated fat, the amount of unsaturated fat in that cooking oil, and make a very informed decision. The other controversial thing would be about the fruits. So which fruits should you consume? Again, this goes back to the availability, accessibility, the family values that you have. And I would encourage you to consume the fruits as snacks. So, and so the reason why you're actually consuming your fruits as snacks is because you want to, of course, maintain your blood sugar levels. And when you consume the food, it's obviously going to have the carbohydrates. So you want to ensure that you have the correct balance. And again, this depends on whether you actually did carbohydrate counting and whether you actually are using the glycemic index method for you to be able to know how much fruit you need to consume. I also would recommend that you actually take the real fruit as opposed to the juice. That way, again, you do not spike your blood sugar levels at very high amounts. So the fruit choices can be from pineapples, mangoes, bananas, depending on you and your blood sugar level and what spikes it more than the other. So make sure that you also understand that part. So again, to also summarize this, I also get a lot of questions about the supplements and whether you need to consume any supplements when you're diabetic. I need to clarify on that, because the thing is, if you're diabetic and you're taking a supplement, please ensure that that supplement has been diagnosed by your doctor, because if it has not been diagnosed by your doctor, it might inhibit the work of insulin or the medication that you're actually taking in. So run it by your doctor before you can actually self-medicate. And again, of course, to be very cautious about the supplements that claim to actually heal diabetes.
So be able to always run the supplements by your doctor or any other health practitioner that you have been following their guidance from. So I do hope that this video has been helpful to you. And again, the diabetes maintenance subject is quite a long subject, so I would still be available for any other questions as well as any other type of assistance that you might want. In case you want me to assist you to plan your meals, please go ahead and reach out to me on my email. And until next time, please always remember that you are what you eat, so make sure that you are doing it right. Bye now.